Okay, good morning to Paris, good afternoon for people from our region and eventually as people from different places. I saw in the list a few people joining. First of all, I'm very glad to give a talk at this webinar OIE. Thank you, Law and OIE colleagues, for bringing Imre in this discussion. And I have to state straightforward that actually Imre is only one of the partners in Vietnam working on various issues of ASF, including communication. So in the next 15 minutes, I will show the collective effort of different partners in Vietnam, Laos, and Cambodia addressing risk communication related to ASF. I will talk a bit about ASF situation in this region, but I think that I will skip it quickly because our colleague from Paris just mentioned it. But you know, focusing mainly on the activity done in ASF risk communication and drawing from that some of the lessons learned and reflection and conclusion. You see, this is actually the update of ASF situation in Asian. By you know a few days ago by FAO together with OIE, I already saw some difference in number between the number given by our colleague from OIE and the number we have from here. For example, in Vietnam, actually we had the first case in February this year, and until today, most of the province, 62 out of 63 of the province reported outbreak. And already about 3.7, 3.8 million pigs die because of ASF. Let me skip this slide, but you can see that it started in China. And afterwards, you know, we have Vietnam, Cambodia, and recently Laos found it. Actually, and here for the case of Vietnam, you can see actually the increase of the speed of having an outbreak of ASF. As I said before, 3.8 million pigs already have been already killed in response to this outbreak in different provinces. When you look at this situation, you see the Southeast Asia in general, and in particular in Vietnam, we share a few characteristics leading to the high risk factors for ASF. For example, in particular for Vietnam, we have a kind of long borders with different countries, and that facilitated a lot the movement of people and animals for that. A lot of international travels to Vietnam with many people carrying various products here and there. But more importantly, our pig production system is very much dominated by the smallholders with various level of biosecurity, but in particular, yeah, basically with very low biosecurity for smallholders. And also you see with the habit of having a lot of pork in our diet, and you know, pork represents 60% of our diet, so that is important source of protein, of animal source food. And also, you know, because even not it's not zoonotic disease, the risk communication sometimes, you know, go in the way that people might stop eating pork when they heard about African swine fever. In response to this situation, actually the government of Vietnam have actually introduced many actions to prevent and control this African swine fever problem. For example, you know, the government put in place various action plan, also different directives and guidance from the Ministry of Agriculture and Rural Development, and also other ministries. And in particular, African swine fever goes up to the level that attract a lot of attention because the party of Vietnam has also issued a directive to address this African swine fever. In the context of Vietnam, you know, if the party issue a directive, it means that it shows a very high level of importance because it's not about the action of the Ministry of Agriculture and Rural Development anymore. It is also the action and the engagement of other sectors, other ministries, other component of our society to address this African swine fever. The most updated policy development. Actually, it was a decision issued on 27 of June by our Prime Minister on the mechanisms, policies, and amended compensation schemes in prevention and control of African swine fever. So basically, we see a few areas of intervention and of controlling African swine fever by working on the movement control of pigs in the country, strengthening the biosecurity application, and as I said before, for the smallholders, pig production system, it is more challenging because they have low level of biosecurity. The commercial farm and large farm have a much better biosecurity level. That's why until now, most of the outbreak happened for the smallholder. Few outbreaks started being observed in large farm. A lot of this communication to raise the public awareness has been implemented, and also the compensation schemes for farmers. Of course, the animal health workers work a lot to identify outbreak, to certify, to put it on the compensation schemes. But of course, the payment of compensation is in limited various depending on the availability of fund of different province in Vietnam. Okay, this is a little bit the context. Now, moving to the action linked to the risk communication for ASF, what did we do? It's not about INRI alone, but also on the partners. So you see that we contacted our colleagues from OIE who connected us to people from FAO in the country, but also Ministry of Agriculture and Rural Development, together with National Agriculture Extension Centers in Vietnam, who work on the translation of some of the OIE materials for ASF, targeting a few key actors of big value chain in Vietnam. So you see that we coordinated very nicely with different partners, and we put the things in Vietnamese. It was approved by various levels of the military, but also from OIE. We put different logos to show the partnership, and we put these materials online on Facebook and various websites in Vietnam, in particular the Facebook of INRI in Vietnam. So I know that, you know, people, our colleagues from Ministry of Agriculture and Rural Development, from extension centers and other organizations have used also these materials to print out, to distribute, and also to post online in the context of Vietnam. So we focus here, for example, you have here the management so for animal health people, for the farmers, for the biosecurity levels, different principles of biosecurity. Unfortunately, I don't have all the data on the distribution, but for example, if you count it, if you count the distribution on the Facebook, so we have about 10 million reach, 1 million, 10,000 reach, 1,000 engaged, and 75 share only for the web, from the website of INRI. So that's actually what we can count. You remember that, you know, a few months after Cambodia had this outbreak of ASF in a province next to Vietnam in the south, and actually we communicated with people from there, but really the action was taken up quickly by a colleague from GDAF, General Directorate of Animal Health and Production under the Ministry of Agriculture of Cambodia, and our colleague from FAO. So, I mean, Cambodian partners, they went very fast. They translated the document in Khmer and actively distributed it in various channels. So I talked with our colleague from Cambodia and understood that GDAF worked with different provincial office of animal health and production to give this document to farmers and other stakeholders linked to the pig pork value chain, but also they organized different training for people and for animal health, and they could also engage the private sectors to give support to print documents like CP and other companies. The latest development of that is, in fact, yesterday, 31st of July, Prime Minister of Cambodia has signed an advice document on prevention and control of ASF, and also emphasized on the import-export of pork product in and out of Cambodia. So I think that is actually nicely addressed the situation. also for Laos. Laos is more recent for ASF, but people in Laos from the Ministry of Agriculture and Forestry, together with colleagues from SDC, Laos Upland Rural Advisory Services, and our communication staff of INRI based in Laos, have worked on the translation, and materials have been sent to every province in Laos and disseminated through provincial offices. So as the latest news I got from this morning, more than 3,500 downloads from the website lao44.org. But I think that this document would be important also to be printed and distributed with some of the support from different organizations, hopefully. So that is about working on the document of OIE. From a research point of view, we have been engaged in talking with different media on African swine fever, for example. Here, we talk with ASEAN Today, with Reuters, with Diplomat, and other local newspapers to show our view from research and communication on how to address African swine fever, in particular in favor of smallholders in different countries. So actually, it's not about research alone, but really spreading the research news, which the media is on very important channel, because it can reach out a lot of people in this crisis of African swine fever. Scientists have been also engaged in different conferences and meetings to talk about African swine fever from the regional level. You might remember we had a big international conference called ISTWI in Chiang Mai in November 2018, where FAO and OIE, I think, put together a very important session on African swine fever, attracting a lot of attention at that conference last year. More recently, INRI, together with University of Sydney, organized a regional workshop on pig research focusing on smallholders. And there we have a panel discussion and one session on animal health. And you know, we talked a lot about African swine fever, both from research and also potential on intervention. We had also African Swine Fever International Conference organized by our colleague from Vietnam National University of Agriculture in April 2019. Where we sent our colleague from Nairobi, Kenya, to talk about African swine fever. So don't forget that African swine fever was detected and discovered in Africa, in Kenya. So actually, INRI have a headquarters there, and we have been conducting research on African swine fever for the last 13 years, and also many conferences organized by local organizations in Vietnam, also in Laos, in Cambodia, presenting African swine fever. So it's very good for communication, basically making people understand the importance of that things and how to address in that context. I would end this communication part by saying that you see, African swine fever is new to Asia, but it has been there for many years with Africa. So our institute has been working there for long and coming up with quite substantial evidences on transmission, on control, on prevention. And here, for example, one of the communication material we have developed for the African context based on the evidence, you know, guiding people how to strengthen their biosecurity, but how to slaughter pigs when they are infected and in the safe way, and then how to kill pigs also when they are infected in the African context. So I don't go into detail, but you know, we have a little bit more experience in Africa because of African swine fever history in that continent. From a policy making point of view, for the case of Vietnam and Cambodia, as far as I know, our minister and vice minister have very must be actively engaged in communicating this African swine fever risk to different stakeholders. You can see here in the photos the Minister of Agriculture and Rural Development of Vietnam on the top, and on below is the Vice Minister in charge of this crisis, ASF. So I think that the message from the ministries has been very clear that, you know, we mobilize effort to fight African swine fever, talking a lot with the media. However, there are also difficulties in communicating with people, because by nature African swine fever is not a zoonotic disease, so it doesn't affect people, but some people still misunderstand, or by some reason of behavior and practice, they stop eating pork, and that is not good for the context of food security and nutrition and the implication for the pig sectors at the moment. So I think that the communication need also to be clear and strategic in the way to target audience and make them really understand the nature of the disease. Another concern recently in Vietnam, as far as we observe, is actually the information on the vaccine development. Our colleague from Hanoi, Vietnam National University of Agriculture, has made a great progress in research on African swine fever vaccines, because they obtained quite good result in the field testing. And actually some of the, but the vaccine is not available. This is very clear. Our minister also said very clearly that, this is very good news, but having the vaccines developed and having the vaccine in the field for farmer to use is not there yet. It might be still a long way to go. But some of the media didn't reflect this message in the correct way. And they run a few titles that, Vietnam successfully developed African swine fever. And actually some of work need to be improved in terms of education of media people to really correctly communicate the result of some of its research. I think that the situation is similar to China, because China researcher informed a few months ago on the success of progress of ASF vaccines development, but officially the vaccine is not available both for Vietnam and China until today. Okay, let me wrap up for this. I think that's the first point you can say that it's very clear that African swine fever has caused important loss for small and medium scale sectors, pig production, affecting food security, and of course some social issue in the country. That I mentioned from the beginning, even our party issues a directive and actually involved many sectors and people working on that. The government in different countries took serious action on African swine fever rapidly, but the communication on African swine fever is sometimes slow, and lack of communication materials at local level. So various partners have been working to improve that. Now it's much better. Now, you remember that from the beginning, some of the private sectors produce themselves the material communication materials to distribute to farmers, and now more people work on that. I mentioned before that there are some local media issue making public confused about zoonotic characters of the disease, but also the vaccine development, and that need to be improve. Generally, we appreciate very much media effort, because that goes very fast, and it may help people to understand the situation, but some areas of improvement need to be done. Translation of African swine fever materials and online distribution is reaching audience quickly. There has not been a lot of adaptation and tailored to the local context. We did a bit, but I think that we are not there yet. So I think that maybe would be good to have a second generation of contextualized and country-specific materials, taking the OIE, but also revise a bit based on the context that we are having. Engage in different communication platforms is important for different partners, in particular researcher for interview conference, help being spreading the news of African swine fever. I think that it's also important for different organizations to develop a different talking voice and message for influencers and experts, important in order to mitigate sensational news. When it goes from important people, it goes better in terms of communication. And finally, the risk communication is not in the hand of anyone in our society. So that's why the effort of working closely with the government, with industry, with media, to achieve good communication activities is key in risk communication. So that's actually our experience from the region. And I would like to thank the contribution of many colleagues at INRI with whom I prepared this talk, but also our colleague from Ministry of Agriculture and Rural Development, from VNUR, from FAO, and some of this work have been supported by ASEA, Australian Centre International Agriculture Research, our CGA Livestock Research Programme and Agriculture for Nutrition and Health. And with that, I end my talk here and I thank you very much for the attention.